Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Azmanov. I do all things food and cake. So if you like eating good food, decorating cakes, cake recipes, then this channel is for you. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell. Today I'm sharing with you a potato soup. This one is made in a slow cooker. I also make it in an instant pot and maybe next week, hopefully, I will share with you that. But today I'm going to show you a very effortless way of making a potato soup in a slow cooker, and though it takes a long time to cook, it feels like as if you're not doing anything at all. So let's get started. Now in my slow cooker I'm going to put some potatoes which I have peeled and diced and washed. Over that I'm going to put some garlic. You can add onion, raw onion at this time, but I prefer to add cooked onion and I do it later, and I'll show you that in a while. Now I have a bouquet garni here which is with a little bit of thyme, parsley or cilantro and some celery leaves. Okay, over that I'm going to put my vegetable stock, close the pot and put it on low for about 4 to 5, 6 hours, okay, until the potatoes get soft. Now this is after 5 hours. I'm using fingerling waxy potatoes today, which actually hold the shape very well, which I normally like because I like a little texture in my soup. But if you use, for example, starchy potatoes like russet or Yukon Gold, you will have a much more smoother texture. So choose potatoes that you like, and either or is perfectly fine. Now, as I said, I want the flavor of the bouquet garni, but I do not want them in my soup. I do not want to mash them up, so I'm going to remove them. Now, I'm going to mash my potatoes. There are two ways to do this. You can either do this with a potato masher like I am. That will give you a little texture in your soup. Or you can use a hand blender and that will give you a much smoother consistency. Okay, either or is fine depending on the preference you have. This is oil, butter and flour. I'm going to make a little paste of this first. I'm going to cook up the flour. Then I'm going to add some milk and that is going to thicken even more. Okay, so this is going to add a lot of thickness to your soup and it's going to add a lot of flavor. So it's kind of going to give it that comfort food kind of thick consistency. Okay, there you go, that's the milk. And I'm going to now continue to cook this on low flame until I have a nice thick consistency. I like to use just a few sautéed onions. They look nice and they taste nice. First, I'm going to season with some salt and pepper. I'm going to add some parmesan and some cheddar cheese. This is parmesan and some cheddar. Okay. I'm going to stir this all nicely. Now you always want to taste and adjust any seasoning at this point of time before you serve it. But I'm going to add a little more salt and I also still have to add my onions, okay? And I like to do that at the last because onions can color your, I don't want to lose the pretty color of my soup, so that's the onions, okay? Now again, this is optional, you don't have to. You can even add raw onions at the beginning of the soup. And that's it, that's my soup already. I'm going to serve this into bowls and I'm gonna top it up. I'm gonna serve it with some parmesan shavings on top, and that's it, it's done. Well, that was my slow cooker potato soup. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell for notifications. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you on my next video. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye for now.